Alrighty, I am back. Yeah, yeah. Adjusting my microphone real quick. Then time to get into some Bloodborne because I've been having a hankering to play this. I just got really too many good video games to play, honestly, anymore. I think that's really what the problem is. Too many good video games to play. Too many games that I love to play. A lot. But hey, we're gonna play some Bloodborne now. Going from The Witcher to playing this, I don't know how good I'll do or how good I'll be, but we'll see. I wanted to go to Iosefkas Clinic, the back way, today in this. As you can see, we're at the Forbidden Woods, and I think I'm going to kind of try and take a shortcut. I want to look at my inventory really quick. I got a saw cleaver, a kirk hammer, a rifle spear, a threaded cane. I didn't know the threaded cane scales with arcane. I kind of been wanting to have like an arcane type character. But we're going to stick with the kirk hammer for now. Even though it is slow. Oh wow, I forgot. Roll is not X. Try the big hammer version. Actually, no, let's not. Thank you, sir. Bloody massacre. But yeah, I decided I felt like playing some Bloodborne now, so I really do like this game. I still remember when I first picked it up, and it was so hard for me because I never had played a Souls game before. Yeah, I never had played a Souls game before. Oh, wow. Oh, it's because I'm locked on. That's why am I not rolling? Yeah, apparently you don't roll when you lock on, you only quick step. Come on, doggy. And I forgot that this is a lot more fast-paced than the Souls game. I played all the Souls games in reverse order. Yeah, I know I'm gonna get torn up here. But yeah, like I was saying, I played all the Souls games in first order. Oh! Wrong way. Yeah, I love it when you take me with the hammer. Now throw your hammers in the air if you just don't care. I love it when you hit me with the hammer. Take this little shortcut right here. Now, I want to say that it is somewhere over yonder. Wrong yonder. Wrong yonder. Now I got their attention. It's okay. Very long visceral window as well. I forgot. But yeah, like I was saying, I played all the Souls games in reverse order. Which is kind of different because you go from, this is extremely fast paced compared to the other Souls games, and to go from playing this to a Souls game, it's just a lot different. But I have been watching the Dark Souls 3 demos and gameplay from GamesCon or whatever. There's a couple of different demo tapes that I've seen or demo videos. And let me tell you about how fucking excited I am for Dark Souls 3. It looks to be the best of both worlds. And I honestly cannot wait. It is going to be so much fun. Wow, I'm just getting bopped up here. I kind of want to use a different weapon, though, because I always use the sword. I'm kind of not feeling that right now. I want to play around with some different weapons, like a transformed saw cleaver and a transformed saw spear, since you can still have your pistol out while you do that. It's like a whole different weapon set. Although, going from this game to other Souls games, it is kind of disappointing to see the lack of weapons. But the transform mode makes it seem like there are different weapons. Like, you go from having a short... Basically, this would be like, I don't know, a short sword, if you will. Long sword. And they have... Well, I'm going to call this... This is the broadsword. Saw spear is the long sword. Ludwig's holy blade, great sword. Kirk hammer, great hammer. You see where I'm going with this? Anyway. Somebody just killed themselves, but yeah, we're actually going to come down back around this way and hit Iosefka's clinic. So let's get us some antidotes, and we should probably get those out. I also want to try and make a blood tinge character, but I feel like that style of play would be very hard. Hey, Mr. Nitty, what are you doing, bud? No, don't claw my couch. Sorry. My rambunctious cat. Ram's cat. And there isn't too much of that I want down here, so I'm gonna run past Jug Boy here. Nope. A bunch of nope. There are some snakes. Skirt. Oh, got the poison. Not what I wanted. But it's cool because we're just gonna pick up this frenzied cold blood and be out again. But yeah, there was a reason I wanted to go to Iosefka's clinic, and that will soon be apparent. Up we go, up, 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 up. And one other thing, the brain sucker guys, they are very resistant to slash damage, but susceptible to thrust damage. I have never tested out the Kirk hammer on them, so I'm going to see if they're susceptible to smash face giant hammer damage. Hammer time, if you will. I love how the giant-ass fucking hammer just disappears. Oh, gameplay mechanics. But my hunter does look really cool. But... Oh, there's my neck! You know, I always thought you didn't have a neck when you had a helmet on. Anyway, I am wearing the Iron Yarhrgul helm. Status ailments can be cured with items. Nothing is... a good substitute for good physical defense, in my opinion, and that's just the way I play most games. We got some cold blood dew, and actually we hit this device, and that is the front of Iosefka's clinic. See? But we want to go this way. This way, another day, another day, another day. Walking through this nasty ass place. Coffins everywhere and shit. Now, where's the brain sucker? Should be right over here. I might get whooped. I might not. Oh, really? Smash damage. Oh, very susceptible to smash damage. Really? Man, get out of here. Okay, saw cleaver time it is. Now we're gonna pick up this madman's knowledge. And apparently, you can't knock it off. No rocks come up, no Estus Flask shards. Estus Flask shards, sorry. But yes, no Estus flash shards for us. So now we are up here, rooftop bopping. Rooftop bopping. What? What? Apparently none of my attacks work. I'm starting to pick something up. That happened on the witch ship. Or as well, I should say. Oh. Hey, what are you doing? Now, if I remember correctly, there isn't any items on this roof. Yeah, not that I see. And watch the insight meter. Dun 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 dun. Now, I also never talked to Iosefka on the first run through after the fake Iosefka replaces her, just because I wanted to see what happens here. We'll get the torch out, because I know YouTube's gonna make it dark. Before we go over there, we're gonna go this way. Oh, wow. Take notice of homeboy right here. Notice the silver blood that flies out everywhere. And a pungent blood cocktail. That enemy is actually the guy that called us alive. I never leave him alive at any playthrough because he is an asshole. Now we go in here. And we can look. I just love this environment. The environment of this game I will just always love. I am a huge fan of the Victorian era, and I don't know why. We actually got another rune right there, and we can see what looks like one of these blue guys being dissected right here. And that, in my opinion, that just goes to show that these are experiments and not normal enemies. But now we can go this way. Pop open this door.
Ah, moonlit sense. How did you worm your way in here? Well, I won't make any excuses. Would you mind leaving us alone? But if you refuse to leave. Oh well. I always wanted to try my hand on a hunter.
And you can go up there and fight her right now, but I need her for an endgame thing. So I'm going to go this way. Back out this way we go. She plays a more pivotal role later in the story. We are already there. Skirt, so we go this way. And this lady right here. I'm so sorry. I am so sorry, Iosefka. This is the real Iosefka. That is an Iosefka's blood vial, and you can only pick up one at a time. Cane her summons, very important item. An old bloodstained summons inviting the honored guest to the forsaken castle Canehurst. Rather bafflingly, it's addressed to you. Do not hesitate. The stagecoach leaves from Hemwick Crossing. That actually is a very important item for a side quest, which I am going to do because I like that area and hate it at the same time. Martyr Logarius has given me the most trouble out of any boss in any game. And as you can see, we are now back where we started. And if you go back up this door right here, this is where Iosefka was standing before when she gave us the blood vials in the very beginning of the game. And sorry, I didn't get that on film because I didn't do that because I was testing something else. But we are now going to go to the Hunter's Dream and level up. Where's Dolly at? Actually, before we level up, I want to come here and see something. Saw spear. DD. It does have thrust attacks. One of the trick weapons of the workshop commonly used by those who dedicate themselves to the hunt. This saw, effective at drawing blood to beast, transforms into a medium-range spear. Saw with a set of bloodline teeth has become a symbol of the hunt, only grows in effectiveness. I've actually never used the saw spear or hunter axe during playthroughs. I always use strength weapons, and I don't know why. Oh, it's only 1,000. Yeah, I'll buy it. It's only 1,000. Try it. I think that looks a lot cooler. Here's a thrust attack, more slashing attacks. Sorry, I'm just kind of having fun right now.
The moon is close. It will be a long hunt tonight. If the beasts loom large and threaten to crush your spirits, seek a holy chalice, as every hunter before you has. A holy chalice will reveal the tomb of the gods, where hunters partake in communion. Most of the holy chalices lie deep within the tomb of the gods, and the few that found their way to the surface were lost again in the hands of men. But if the old hunter tales remain true, one of the holy chalices is worshipped in the Valley Hamlet. Yet the town is in disarray. It was burned and abandoned for fear of the scourge, home now only to beasts. The perfect place for a hunter, wouldn't you say?
I always wondered if his peg leg was eaten off or what. What do I want to upgrade? I don't know what I want to upgrade. And these both. Oh, I forgot I had the tinnitus. And the tinnitus actually scales better with strength than anything else. Let's do the saw spear. And where's my lady?
Welcome home. What is it? Very well. Let me.
I think I'm gonna switch up and make this a skill guy.
Farewell, good hunter. May you find.
Not farewell just yet, m'lady. Gotta use my bloods. Yeah, sorry, I don't mean to switch up my playstyle mid-game, but I want to play a different style. I always just play a super strength tank cannon, dude.
Welcome. What is it? Very well, let me...
Okay. What's my Kirkhammer got? Oh, Kirkhammer's got some craziness. And the Threaded Cane and Saul Spear actually, let's see what I got here. Oh, that helps with the skill scaling. This is actually better than anything else, so we'll do that. This... apparently it has the same exact slots. Oh, it has waning at the end. Alright, and... the Saw Cleaver. 7, 3, 5, 4, 2. Alright, so it's triangle. Okay, I don't have triangle. Alright, but my cane has a triangle. Alrighty. Don't mind me. And we did get some new runes, so I'm gonna check my runes. This one is Lake, physical damage reduction. Bolt damage reduction, add slow poison resistance. This is max vials up 1, max vials 3. We'll take the HP, we'll take the stamina, and we don't have anything else. Alright. And what weapon do I have? Alright, I got the Kirkhammer just in case I get into a bad situation. Alrighty, and we're off to Bergynwerth then? Bergynwerth. Yep, we're off to Bergynwerth. And now that I think about it, this game actually really isn't that long. Oh, no sedatives. No sedatives. That's gonna... oh, I don't know how this is gonna work, but we'll try it. I kinda like this move set on this one. I'm not a big rifle spear fan, and these guys can be nasty. That tree root is a table laying on the ground. This is what I like to do. A little mushy-mushy on them. Sweet sedatives. We'll equip that right now because we may need that. And I might bust out my sword here in a second because there is a hunter in there that is not fun. I kind of really like the moveset on the Saw Spear. Oh, we're going to need a thrust attack. Okay, this is about to not be fun. I hate these guys so much. They fuck me up so bad for no reason all the time. Except for the one I crushed. Visceral! Yes. And notice those guys bleed silver blood as well. Arcane Lake Rune. We'll look at that as soon as we go back to check our runes. I kind of like my giant Saw Spear. It's like a long sword. See, this is what I mean. Long sword. You see how it's a lot smaller? It's a little bit quicker than the Saw Cleaver. But it's skinnier, has less damage. But that's what I mean. It goes from being the short sword class to long sword class instead of the broad to bastard sword class, if that makes sense to anyone. Now I gotta take care of these fly guys. It's the fly guys. Not the fly guys. Come here. Did he take damage from falling? Oh no 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 no. Back. Foul demons. Foul demons. Oh, frenzy. Don't frenzy me. Don't frenzy me. Don't frenzy me. For this guy. Yeah, you ain't getting me with that, John. Really? That still didn't kill him? Huh. Well, that was something else. Bone marrow ash specifically for this part. I don't think there's items over here. Nah. Well, right there, yeah, but... Oh, no, 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 no. I hate these things so much. Do I not have good enough blood gemstone yet? Or something like that? Why is it only doing 100? Okay, it might be time to change the strategy. Maybe not. Whoa, back, son. This is not what I expected. Alright, might have to Kirk hammer this bad boy down. He kind of reminds me of the Gaping Dragon. There we go. That is exactly why you keep the Kirk Hammer on deck. A lot of enemies are susceptible to blunt damage. And then we come over here, fight homie. More sedatives, just what we need. Although I might see if I can fire paper this person, because we're gonna need quick attacks, because they have the threaded cane, which is very quick. Now I'm going to run the fuck over here. You know what, I might switch to the Kirk Hammer for this one, because this NPC is really powerful. They give me a lot of trouble. That is not good. I hate Augur. Come on, man. Finally. That can be a pretty hard NPC fight, in my opinion. Not as hard as another guy, but pretty hard. And this place, for how big it is in the story, they did not do it justice at all. This is the famed College Bergynwerth, where the ritual blood was discovered. The source to everything was discovered. Well, it was actually discovered in the chalice below. But, this is the place that, Master Lawrence actually was working with Wilhelm, and their paths differed. And for, and for such an important place in the story, this place is not big enough, in my opinion, at all. Don't get me wrong, though. I still love the game, and I love the fucking atmosphere of this place. But it just did not do it justice, in my opinion. Up we go. And I love the giant globe just hanging from the ceiling. Looks like a gyroscope. A chandelier gyroscope. The Lunarium key, which is very good. We need that to progress with the story. Then we come up here. Nothing of interest right here. Then we come up here. And Johnny Two Socks. Bye. Bye-bye, Johnny Two Socks. We can probably open this up before he gets back up. Pick it up before he gets back up. Is how you defeat him. Don't know if I can survive this, but let's try. La 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 la. And just like that, well, when the red moon hangs low, the line between man and beast is blurred, and when the great ones descend, a womb will be blessed with a child. Anyway, that is essentially Bergynwerth. That is Bergynwerth. Yes. You open this with the Lunarium key. You meet the man himself, Master Wilhelm. Let's talk to him real quick. He doesn't have a fucking thing to say. And this might displease some people, but he is obviously of not of sound mind anymore. He has ascended into retardation. So, bye. Notice how he bleeds silver blood. That is how you know he is ascended. And we will deal the mercy blow with the Kirk Hammer. And we actually get an eye rune from that. And right about now, I am running low on blood vials, and I am running low on bullets, so I think I'm going to just make a quick run back to the Hunter's Dream. And then when I come back, we have opened up all the shortcuts, so when I come back from the Hunter's Dream, we can actually fight Rom then, which is the boss of this area, and then we are actually done with the area, and that's what I mean by they did not do this place justice. I guess you could consider the path through the Forbidden Woods part of Bergynwerth, but that just isn't cool to me. They should have made this place as big as the Forbidden Woods, and the Forbidden Woods as big as Bergynwerth, in my opinion. But now to the Hunter's Dream. Next time I will level up and we will fight Rom. So I guess I will see you guys later and smash!